Hey, another day in paradise or isolation, with your choice. Somehow you are watching children for the day. You need to have projects. Cooking projects are always fun. And I like to do pudding with kids. It's easy, not a lot of mess, and it keeps them busy because you're going to tell them it's going to take at least an hour. Technically it is, but only about 15 minutes of it is cooking time. The rest is chilling time. So it sits in the refrigerator to a point where they can eat it and not burn off their taste buds off their tongue. So what we need is a half a cup of sugar, 1/4 of a teaspoon of salt. And when you see a recipe that's written out and it says a small tea or a small TSP, that means teaspoon, tiny spoon, little teeny tiny spoon. Our next ingredient is cornstarch. We need 3 tablespoons. Oh my gosh, that's a great big tea. So it must be a different spoon and not 3 of those little ones. It is the big spoon, it's the great big, the biggest one of them all. So you've got 1/2 cup of sugar, 1/4 cup of salt, 3 tablespoons of cornstarch, and I throw those into the stock pot that I'm gonna cook in. I'm bad, and I always put in my vanilla at that point. The alcohol's gonna burn off one way or another, and so I don't care. This bottle I get in Mexico, and this costs the same amount as that teeny tiny one you get at the grocery store. So I don't care, I can put in extra. So I'm gonna mix that up really good, make sure that all the clumps are out. You don't want a great big coagulated one of salt. Ooh, that would be awful, awful. So in my blender, I'm gonna put in 2 eggs. I'm gonna crack them, and I'm not including the shell, people. No, not whole egg. No, just the white and the yolk. Okay, we got it. All right, so we're gonna put in to the blender. I'm gonna have it blend for about 10 seconds, and then I'm gonna put in the first of 1 cup of milk, and we're gonna need a total of 2. Milk comes in all kinds of stages. We've got 1%, 2% D, we've got a whole. We've got soy. We've got this one, which we're using today, which is cashew milk. And my other favorite is almond milk. Technically, those aren't milks, but we are going to use it anyway. So I'm going to add the milk 1 cup at a time with the eggs in the blender until it's nice and frothy. Now we're ready to go. I'm going to go over to the stove with my stock pot that I'm using. And the rule of thumb with pans and skillets is you want to pick something that's bigger than what you are actually going to need. And that is because you would rather have the splatters and spits in the pan and not all over the front of you or on your backwash. So on the lowest temperature possible, you are going to start stirring, and you'll add a little bit of the liquid. The liquid being the milk and the egg. Stir some more, add some more liquid. Stir some more, add some more liquid until you've got it all the way used. Put down your empty blender because you don't need to be holding it. Now you've got another hand to hold on to the pan that you're stirring in. And now you can increase the heat up to medium, no more than that. And the rule is you do not leave that pan. You will continue to stir because scorched milk can't be fixed. Can't fix stupid. And now, so you're gonna be watching this liquid, and it's starting to start to move, and it looks like it's swelling, and it actually is, because the cornstarch and the egg are getting larger in size. They're binding and making it thick. So when you see bubbles start to come and you don't, you can't stir them down, turn down that temperature, and now you've got it to cook on the lowest temperature for 60 seconds, 1 minute. This would be a good time for your kids to count out loud to 60. If they're little kids, they might struggle just getting to 60. If they're older kids, have them do it in Spanish or French or Mandarin, something. But you pay attention to the time yourself in case they make an error in their counting. Oh, now, turn off the heat, take your skillet or your stock pot, whatever you use, move it to a cold burner so it doesn't keep on cooking. Now, Martha Stewart says that when you're doing pudding, that you should be pouring that pudding in through a sieve. And that is so that it all of those lumps that might have happened, you can get rid of them. But if you did it in the way that we just described it, you won't have any lumps. You can either have it chilling in one big bowl, or you can put it into individual bowls. No matter what you choose to do, plastic wrap over the top will prevent it a skin from happening. Let it chill for that period of time that we discussed, at least until an hour, and then you can use it for leverage, whether or not the kids are going to eat it then, or they're going to wait until after dinner. But they also have something else that they can think about, and that is garnish. If we are using smaller children, I would say berries are a very good choice to use. With the holidays coming, I'm really bad with having chocolate or anything like that around the house. It's just like Halloween. I buy the good stuff first, and then as always, not my favorites that are left over. But one of my favorite ideas is to take a Cadbury egg, and there's no way I'm going to put a whole Cadbury egg in there. It's going to get halved, and I'm going to make sure that the filling that's inside, whether it's the cream filling or the caramel, equally goes into each of the two pieces that we cut in half, and I'm going to stick it down into the top of pudding. If you're thinking in advance, you could have taken shredded coconut and dyed it green, and that makes it look like an Easter basket. It's very cute. Or whipped cream up on the top of it with a scattering of some Mike and Ike's, and that's a little splash of color. Same thing with the chocolate M&Ms. So, easy enough? Yeah. Too easy, actually. But don't tell them that was easy. Let them think it was tough. But they fixed it, and they helped. So until the next time, thank you for viewing.